From a skull such as this, anthropologists have been able to show us how some prehistoric men probably looked. They had low foreheads and thick skulls. They were generally shorter and stockier than modern men, but they walked more or less erectly. Their hands were much like our hands. Somehow these men learned to use their hands to grasp objects. A stone could be used as a simple tool. A stick could be handled as a simple weapon. Now men had more than their bare fists to use in the struggle to live. An even greater discovery was made when early men learned that they could shape a piece of flint by chipping it with another stone. This was one of the first. Some of them took shelter in caves, and in some way, they had made one of the greatest discoveries of man. They had learned the use of fire. Can you imagine civilization without fire? With fire, prehistoric man could keep himself warm, and he could cook his food. Much of the food was meat brought in by the hunters, who killed game with their stone-tipped weapons. Prehistoric hunters painted animals they knew on the walls of their caves. This is a wild horse, as some cave artists drew him thousands of years ago. These pictures are the beginning of art, another achievement of prehistoric man. We can imagine how, by the flickering light of simple oil lamps, prehistoric artists painted pictures of the wild animals they hunted. Sometimes the cavemen carved figures of animals on cave walls and rock ledges. What other contributions did early men make? Let's imagine a scene around a campfire. Some wild dogs are attracted by the men. However it happened, we know that the taming of wild animals was another. Near the end of the Old Stone Age, hunters were tracking game with the help of their wolf-like dogs. In their constant search for game, the hunters wandered far and wide.